Hello, Lola's.
Oh, Brooklyn, Brooklyn, Brooklyn. So, I went into labor and I was just like, didn't think it was real labor. I thought it was false labor, but nope, it was real labor. And she came just as happy as can be. Yeah. And she, Auntie Kay Holland, got her some special nursers where she actually drinks her milk all the way down. Some people call them disappearing milk, because it surely disappeared right into her little tummy, her little fat tummy. It's just a fat old thing. So, Miss Andy, can I ask you your opinion? Yeah, child, whatever you want, I got the answer, honey, because you know I done lived a long life. I know, but, so you know the situation that I was explaining to you about her father. She doesn't want that. Yeah, child, because you done had on that titty all morning. She ain't gonna want that bottle. I could have told you that.
I know, but she was acting like she was hungry.
Every time a child move their mouth don't mean you pop a bottle in their mouth. That's what's wrong with y'all young folks. Y'all want to keep popping bottles and pacifiers in these babies' mouth. Sometimes they just need to sit a while.
Yes or no? Okay. So, I just thought things would be different after Brooklyn came, that, you know, her father would come around more, that he would spend more time with us. And
Lord have mercy, child, you must be been watching too many movies. You can't have a man to hold a, you can't have a baby to hold a man. That just don't work. That's not how you keep a man, honey. A man has to want to be kept. That man is using you, sweetie. I hate to tell you, but you being just a plum old fool.
Miss Andy, I really thought things would be different. I mean, when I was pregnant with her, he was promising me that he would come and, you know, spend more time and, you know, stay with us and stuff. And
child, that man would say anything just to get that old hot pocket. That's why I keep trying to tell you, child, keep your legs closed. These men don't mean you no good.
You think it's somebody else?
Let me see. Well, you didn't see him for Thanksgiving. You didn't see him for Christmas. You had his baby. He wasn't there. Just maybe it might be a little elf on the shelf at his house somewhere. Have you ever been to his house?
No, ma'am. I never really needed to because he always came over here and took me out. And, you know, he bought me plenty of gifts and nice things. And
child, I said, did you ever go to his house? If a man can't never take you where he lay his head, it's probably because he laying it with somebody else.
Miss Andy, oh my gosh, like, why you have to make it sound so terrible? Maybe he's just busy all the time and because it was convenient for him to come over here because I have so many kids and he just feel like it's just easier for me. He was just making it convenient for me.
Oh, that's a bunch of bull. Now, you know what? If you want Miss Andy advice, you better listen, child, because I'm only going to tell you once. That man got another woman, and that's who he's spending all his time and holidays with. You is a side chick, if that. He just got you on the side and something to do. You just like a motor sport. He just riding you till you can't ride no more. That is it, honey. Stop giving in the hot pocket. Move on with your baby. You got a pretty little girl. And just move on. Just move the hell on. And let him be with whoever it is that he got, that he's spending his time with. Because that's who he really want. He ain't wanting you. If he wanted you, that man, you wouldn't be guessing right now. If he loves you and if he wants to be with you and all this stuff, he in no way he wouldn't come over there and see that sweet little sugar lump baby.
I don't know. It's gonna be hard. Cause I really, really love him. I mean, when he do come around, he spends so much time with us and with me, and he, you know, he's just really good to me.
Child, not he good to you with a hot pocket, honey, because I think you're a little confused. How's he good to you? Do he take you out in public, sweetie? Or do he keep you in the house all the time? Are you confined to just four walls and enclosed places? Are you sneaking, running in and out of dog places where he can't take you nowhere? Honey, you need to think about things and think about things real hard. I thought you was a smart gal. I thought you was smarter than that old Nikki. But I don't know, honey. You just not, you're not on your game right now. Oh, sugar book, book. I just don't know if I got the strength to do it. Through so much already. I thought this was the one. I just can't. I can't do it. I don't know. Oh, you hush on up now, gal. You just stop doing all that crying. You gonna make Miss Andy a little sad. Lord, let me pour me another cup, because this is just too much. I can't watch this, honey. Sweetie, you's a good person. You got a good heart, but you give too much. You're giving up the hot pocket. You're giving up too much. You need to take some time and get to know yourself better and stop chasing these men looking for something that they can't give you. You gotta find happiness and love within your own self, not within a man or anybody for that matter. Honey, just take a break. Let Miss Andy get the baby and you go take a nap, sweetie. You look exhausted, a hot mess.